Passengers, we have a technical problem. We'll be moving shortly.
Before the simulator, in order to go out and train, you have to go out when there's no people around because we don't want to hurt anybody.
And you'll hit start.
So that's between midnight and 4. And if you take a class, what it winds up being is everybody's getting maybe a half hour of actual seat time.
Okay, so I'm showing a door open.
On the simulator, they can get 6 to 8 hours in one day.
The simulator makes our operators now more prepared for emergency situations.
Passengers, please stand clear of the doors. This train has a door problem.
We have to go through road manuals. We got to call Central. We got to talk to our passengers.
Central, train 373, I say 75 kilo. I got a red.
And so we're running through all those scenarios.
It's a lot more hands-on now. Before, it was us with a PowerPoint and describing, well, this will happen to you, and then you will hit this button, and then you will hit this button, and try and remember that. So now we put them in front of a simulator and we just say, okay, hit this button, and they hit it, and do this, and they do that, and we can practice it over and over.
Train will move, please train seated.
There's things we can do on the simulator that we can't do in real life.
So what do we do after we've gone out one station out?
So you can simulate emergencies. You can, for example, have smoke on the tracks.
Central, BART emergency, BART emergency.
5-3 copy, you have BART emergency situation status.
We've taught one class now that has come through with the simulator, and it's made a real difference.
They were like, this is like the real thing. I'm not nervous about anything because I've done this. It's like I've done this, even though it was in the simulator. They were very comfortable sitting in the seat.
Very good, Scott.
I think what will happen, what I've already seen, is better quality. People coming out feeling more secure, more comfortable with what they need to know and what they need to do.